silver linings feel and incomplete. Woo, 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 woo. And of course, it is the second day of 2019. I am still pumped. Someone actually commented on YouTube. They're like, Tina, you're pumped? You're what? You're pumped? If you do not get the meaning of me saying I'm psyched or I'm pumped and you try to disturb, instead you just try to get my card. Make a simple, simple English word and pervert it. Don't comment about the words you don't understand that I use. I'm just saying. But anyway, I'm pumped. I hope everybody's having themselves a beautiful 2019 thus far. Without further ado, let's get into what's happening in the world of celebrity in this new year, people. Let's get it. Yeah. Okay, I it's not yet confirmed. We are actually trying to reach out to the different people who can give us the full confirmation, but no. This is my job. It's rumor. Rumor has it, because yesterday when we were looking back at the different things that trended in 2018, we remembered Cute Kaya's whole situation. He was in a very, very disturbing state. Very, very disturbing. Of course, Ugandans, we made so much fun about it. Different people felt empathy and sadness and sorry. So they reached out to him. They pushed him, you know, got him out of where he was. I think they put him in some sort of rehabilitation. I do not know if they rehabilitated him though. Anywho, that whole Cute Kaya story, right? Now, as we were trying to do that, I'm like, yo, by the way, let's follow up. Where is he at? Because last we checked, he was hitting the studios hard because they'd given him free studio time. Different artists who are actually in the same trade back in the day gave him free studio time, the Message Semaculas and all of that. He got himself a sponsor who was pretty much supposed to run everything. So I was like, where is he at? How's he finishing the year? What's going down? We didn't get to see the video. And then I got the saddest news, but I'm hoping it is not true because of Manyi. The different few sources that we called like about two people, and they were like, last time we heard is that things have refused. He's frustrated because even if he got the studio time, he has not got that big break that he wanted again. He hasn't got the comeback. And because it was a habit, addiction was a habit that probably was not, what's that thing called? Rehabilitated. He could have relapsed. I was like, no. Be sure. If he has relapsed, he has relapsed. If he hasn't, he hasn't. And I don't think the relapse would happen that fast, that quick. I was hoping, and I'm still hoping, that the time that he has not been around and he's been quiet, they actually understood that he was addicted to something and they had to put him in rehab for a month or two or three or four, for as long as he needs the time to get well. But well, second phone call also told me the same thing. So as of today afternoon, we're trying to reach out to part of his family members and ask, is he okay? Are the rumors that we're hearing, you know, true? And if it is, sad. That is really sad. That would have been like the worst PSA ever, because we all stood out here and we're like, yo, you've seen what has happened to Cute Kaye. Stop doing drugs. Stop. Like, I mean, we try to reach out and put light on this ish. But hey, about the music, I was actually looking forward to hearing something new from him, you know. Lately, I feel like listening to the most odd sounds. I would like to hear probably Cute Kaye on a song with like, which rapper? One of these new rookies on around, you know. I'd like to hear that, but hey. That's the sad bit that's coming out, but when we do find out, we will let you know. Bebe Cool outed his list. So did other very many insignificant artists. They all outed their list of who they considered owned the year 2018 on the musical scene. Now, of course, as always, whenever Bebe Cool, the first time he outed a list, you remember the uproar it caused. Anyway, he's done it again. He definitely has done it again. So what happened? He sat down, he penned his list, and at number one, he gave it to Fik the Maker. And I feel, yes, Fit for Mecca deservedly got that and earned that. All in all, yes, he released his list. There were a couple of fair situations there. There were very many unfair situations, but that was his opinion. I really don't care much about the list. The part that got me about the list is after he had written even the comedians who made him happy and the single hits or the one hit wonders or whatever, he put like a caption down and he's like, well, as for Chalenga, it was not really a good song because one, he used his political standing for to make it a hit, which I'm not saying it's totally wrong, it's acceptable to me, but musically speaking, it wasn't a good song. I was like, Sally, Bebe, if anything, you would have removed Fefe Busi from that list. You would have removed, there were very many useless people who you put there. Very many useless people. Some of them have just had one hit. Chosen Beke, aine nyimba meka. Aine nyimba meka Chosen Beke. Nae abadeo kuko. I'm just saying. If there was anything, there were very many people who are not supposed to be on the top list, and Chalenga could have sat there comfortably among them, and it would have taken it so well. But no, because you're very cool and you need to be petty and extra and oh my goodness, we are rivals, let's keep it together, I want the following, let me be relevant, oh come on, bebe, even I who has issues with different people cannot begin saying Chalenga was a bad song. Yo, that song is dope. That song has about 9 Ugandan languages in one song. That song has a video. It has a video. In the video, Salvador looked even handsome. What are you saying? That song is not musically upright. Nizo Sagala na Chitwa Lambu politics. I'm keeping it to the music. Now, can you compare your Chalenga to Pasango? Can you? Can you compare Chalenga to Nsirikam? Can you? Atenge bibi mama babi mastering ide yebwe rubidiye bidina waksi munji. Chalenga was just a simply beautiful song. It doesn't even have to be politics in it. It was just a good song. And it was penned down right. It was executed well. Wachete musi mako. I know it's a bitter pill for you to chew or swallow. But you see, what would have got our attention as the masses, because yes, you wanted to get our attention, that you did. But I think what would have caught us off guard would have been if on that list you would have thrown Chalenga in and just said, anyway, because it is just a good song, na yaya luyimba musiru. I would have understood that. You get what I'm saying? I mean, because musically speaking, that song is life. It is beautiful. It is. It is not wasibu kirawa. It is not. It is. Well, bebe, I agree to disagree again some more with this here, your allegations. Why would you go and be that petty, you know? Why? Why? For you to say that the only reason the song got much acclaim is because of the political situation, then dakati kuata yo rubu. Teakola and sibuki in sirikam. I mean, you also have a political standing. What happened to Nsirikam? What trending am kwano? I'm just nzabine bintu basagala bite kam na feeling. And one thing I like about Bebe Cool is that he has it. Like when you talk to Bebe Cool one on one, he's going to tell you my opinion is my opinion. Nange munange sebo, this is my opinion. Chalenga is a dope song. You cannot take that away from it. You cannot obamugenda kweko bazibulit. Do you know funny thing is that I believe Chalenga would have been a dope song even if Bobby Wine hadn't sung it. That's how you know a song is good. Like, Chalenga would have been a hit if someone like Tonix had sung it. It would still be a hit. That's what's beautiful about the song. It's a good song. It's relatable. Why, Sally? Why? I mean, if we gave Chalenga to Hendrix to sing it, it would have been a hit. Maybe now he would stop being a one hit. Wait, I can't call him a one hit wonder. He's what? An upcoming, up and coming or coming artist. Which one is Hendrix? Bebeza. Anyway, that's all I had for you today. It's quite simple. @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are TinaFierce1. Like and follow the page. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's @TinaFierce1 with an H. I'll catch you again tomorrow. I'm out.